My name is Dr. Lara Souza, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Microbiology and Plant Biology at the University of Oklahoma. As a plant ecologist, my research program addresses how global changes, such as invasive species and climatic change, alters the structure and function of terrestrial plant communities, with a focus on grasslands. In this video, I will discuss how climate change has already impacted terrestrial ecosystems, as well as some additional future changes we also expect to see. Terrestrial ecosystems refer to all of the living earthbound things as well as the non-living things that they interact with. This includes sunlight, air, water, and soil. Terrestrial ecosystems provide humanity with a diverse set of benefits called ecosystem services. Some of the services are easily quantifiable, such as the amount of fresh water for drinking or food for survival, while some services are more intangible, such as aesthetic beauty or cultural significance. Climate change, particularly changes in precipitation and atmospheric warming, has already contributed to changes in the terrestrial ecosystem. Research has already shown major shifts in the spatial distributions of many species across a variety of taxa, from plants to butterflies to mammals. For example, plant species in subalpine forests have migrated 29 meters upslope per decade over the last century. Species are migrating north in latitude or upward in altitude to try to track their current climate across space when they are unable to locally adapt to changing climatic conditions. As you can imagine, this migration is much easier for animals such as birds as opposed to large trees such as pines. Complications can arise when two species are interdependent on each other but are migrating at different rates. Similarly, the timing of biological events, also known as phenology, has been altered by climate change. Phenology includes the recurring life cycle stages of organisms, such as the timing of leafing and flowering to fruit maturation in plants, and emergence of insects and migration of birds in animals. Earlier onset of phenological activities, such as sprouting, budding, and blooming, has been attributed to milder winters, earlier spring onsets, and changes in the distribution of rainfall. The consequences of shifts in phenology are immense, especially as they have been shown to disrupt food webs and species interactions. For instance, if flowering time accelerates, then associated insects such as pollinators and herbivores may be mismatched from their plant host unless their phenological shift takes place in the same direction. Both managed and natural ecosystems in the Great Plains are already being influenced by climate change. For example, winter wheat is blooming 6 to 10 days earlier now than it did 70 years ago. Spring temperatures in the region have increased over the same period. Another study in the Southern Great Plains showed that the great majority of mixed grass prairie species have advanced their flowering and fruiting times, while a small proportion have delayed them. The timing of interactions between plants and animals can end up mismatching if parties respond in opposing ways. For example, playa lakes in the southern high plains of Texas serve as important habitat areas for wintering and migrating wildlife, including waterfowl and cranes, with nearly 2 million ducks wintering in such habitat type. These lakes are ephemeral ecosystems and are created by intermittent rainfall events in typically dry areas with extremely hard, rough surfaces. Sustained drought events can reduce seed production by annual plants, an important resource for migratory birds and wildlife, not only in terms of food, but also habitat structure. Global shifts in species distributions or phenological changes can ultimately generate novel communities, altering how local ecosystems function. In our local prairies in the Southern Great Plains, long-term atmospheric warming has led to unprecedented shifts in plant and microbial diversity. These biotic shifts are altering plant litter decomposition, a key ecosystem service associated with releasing carbon back to the atmosphere. While warming promotes the abundance of tougher plant litter, it generates microbes with high activity that speed up litter decomposition. Further, as local ecosystems experience shifts in species distributions and phenological events, they create new challenges for management strategies. Expansion in mountain pine beetle infestation into newer suitable climate areas has contributed to major outbreaks into new forest ecosystems in Western North America. Milder winter temperatures have allowed larger beetle populations to survive from year to year, resulting in an outbreak that is 10 times larger than any other outbreak on record. Consequences of this infestation include reduced timber quality, major forest die-offs, and increases in forest fire frequencies. Land managers must decide between different techniques to control the beetle population in impacted trees, such as pheromone baiting, control burning, and pesticides. Managers must act to both maintain local tree stands and prevent the further expansion of the beetle into new areas. Experiments that manipulate local climate, replicated all over the globe, will provide opportunities to address the context dependency of climate effects across system types. DroughtNet is a coordinated global experimental network that addresses how sensitive grassland ecosystems are to drought, while the Warming by Species Removal Network addresses how concurrent losses of species and climate change will influence ecosystem biodiversity and function. Such next-generation experimental approaches will allow climate scientists to draw generalizations in patterns of terrestrial ecosystem responses to global climate changes and help decision-makers sustain the natural resources under their management.